Okay, now we're going to look at lump sum payments, where you get a big chunk of money and you want to just pay it off your loan. It might be where you get an inheritance or if you're lucky, you've been cross lotto. So let's have a look at a scenario and work out how we solve it. You've got a house for $300,000. The rate is 5.5% per annum and it's compounding monthly. So you're paying it back. After 5 years, you pay a lump sum of $10,000. How much does this save you? Okay, so you're probably thinking, how do we solve that? Well, the same thing is, you've got to enter the data into the calculator like normal. So because we've got to find out the payment, we've always got to start with the payment. So when we do that, we get a payment of $1,703.37 per month to pay off that loan normally. Now the deal is, the thing's been going for the time when you get your $10,000. So now we need to work out how much you owe after the 5 years. So that's using PM1 and PM2 again, which we've done before. So in your calculator, PM1 is 1, PM2 is 5 times 12, because it's 5 years monthly. 360 is the original time of your loan, I is 5.5, your debt is $300,000, and you've got $1,703.37, which comes from the question before. So you go to F1, hit balance, and once you get that, you have a balance of how much you actually owe on the loan. So you're owing $277,381.81. So that's the first part. Now you've got that $10,000 lump sum. So what you do is you just take that off the principal, or the PV. So you have 5.5 as your rate, 277,000 is your balance, which you got from the question before, and you're taking 10,000 away from it, using the same PMT as you had before. The thing is, you don't know what N is. You're trying to find out how long it will take to pay off the loan now that you've taken this extra $10,000 off. So you recalculate that for N, and you'll have 277.95 months, okay? Which rounds up to approximately 23 years. So instead of taking 25 years to pay off the loan, you only take 23, which is pretty good. So you're saving about 2 years. So 2 times by 12, yeah, it's how many months you save, times by how much you're paying, which is $1,703. You save around about $40,000, which is pretty good for that $10,000 lump sum payment.